What's up next is the queen of Sicilian pastries. The cassata siciliana is the most iconic of Sicilian cakes, an elaborate dessert of Arab origin. Once a closely guarded secret in royal households and monasteries, it can now be found all over Sicily. But this particular cassata, available only at Chiesa di Santa Caterina d'Alessandria, is the recipe of the nuns that used to live in this monastery. Traditionally, the first daughters of noble families were expected to enter monasteries. To entertain themselves, they would bake, and because they had the means to procure expensive ingredients like sugar, they created quite a bit of recipes. Today, the very same recipes are baked daily in this spacious kitchen of the monastery.
Certo, allora la cassata nasce in Sicilia da circa 300 anni, è un dolce molto antico. Per fare la cassata occorre uno stampo particolare che è questo. Okay.
Already it looks like a difficult recipe to prepare, as it takes several pastry chefs to do the job. The ingredients are the best of the best of Sicily. Cheese, pistachio, almonds, and candied citrus.
So this is the pan de España, which is a simple pound cake, no?
Esatto.
And then
poi mettiamo questa parte stretta.
A pistachio and almond paste. Pasta di mandorle
e al pistacchio. Okay. Esatto.
Ma con la forma è perfetto così, no?
Sì. Infatti questa forma è fatta proprio per fare la cassata, cioè con questo stampo si fa solo la cassata siciliana.
Ah,
sì.
Okay. So in this pie mold, this is the only the cassata is the only thing that they make in this pie mold.
It begins with pan di Spagna or sponge cake and marzipan already cut into equal rhombus shaped sizes.
So they have to fit in all the pound cake and the paste of the almond and pistachio precisely to cover the entire surface.
Prendiamo il disco.
And then what goes on top is the disc shape from the pan di Spagna to fit perfectly inside.
And then the edges are trimmed.
Oh, that's so cool.
So it's like an assembly line. After the sponge cake and marzipan are set, the ricotta filling is put in the pan.
Oh my God, that's so rich.
Perfecto.
Then it is covered again with small pieces of pan di Spagna, leveled off carefully, before it is put in a blast freezer. This one has already been put in the freezer earlier.
If you use the one that's newly made, the minute you put the hot glaze, the whole cake will just come apart. So this is now the blast frozen cassata. So it's dense and it's ready to be glazed with the sugar glaze
that
Fabrizio's doing. Wow. Quello è caldo, no? La la. So just confectioner's sugar and water.
The last step is to decorate the cassata, and yet another person is assigned to do this task. It's decorated with candied fruit, Sicilian style. The more colorful, the better. Antonietta herself does the final touches. She says the cake has to be beautiful inside and out.
Their cassata, people always comment that it's different from the others that you find in other pasticceria around Palermo or around Sicily. And she says because the recipes are the particular recipes of the nuns that were here in this convent.
Sì, sì, noi abbiamo il libro I segreti del chiostro dove, a parte la storia dei conventi, comunque ci sono anche le ricette.
Okay.
Perché abbiamo avuto questa grande generosità di dare alla città di Palermo, a tutta Italia comunque, la possibilità di poter fare anche a casa queste ricette, sì, che ci hanno lasciato le suore.
Ah, look at that! Like a queen that she is.
So each cake is an artist's expression, so there are no two cakes that are identical. Che bello!
Cassata siciliana, truly the best expression of the melting pot that Sicily is.
Cin cin.